thank you all for being here today. I'm so glad to see so many of you. I always like to do my thank yous in the beginning of a concert. So first of all, to our wonderful musicians, a great round of applause. Grateful to all of them for making this possible in our community. Also to our board members, to anyone who donates to us, our sponsors, anyone that puts money in our donation box. Jason here at this auditorium, he doesn't get enough credit. He is wonderful, Jason. He's so wonderful to work with. He does the setup, he does anything I ask him. I just appreciate it so much. I always come here, it's all set, and I love it. It's wonderful. And MCTV, thank you also for recording us. We'll be on, they run our show periodically, so pay attention if you watch MCTV. You should if you don't. And watch our concerts again, and we appreciate them being here as well. I also want to thank the dancers again. If you could stand up, dancers, and Wade and Vivian. Vivian Stafford and Rose Workhouse, they helped me organize that, so thank you very much. I appreciate it. So February is Black History Month, so I thought it would be nice for this concert to feature some of African-American composers. And while I did that, I thought I would collaborate with some African-American organizations that are in our community that do a wonderful job and give back to our community and help those that need it. So out in our lobby, if you haven't checked it out, their displays are wonderful. If you haven't checked it out yet, the Great Lakes of Jack and Jill, the Alpha Kappa Alpha, Delta Sigma Theta, and Go Back Project, they're all out there, they have displays, and I'm sure there's something that you don't know about those organizations that you should find out, and then hopefully you can help them and check out what they do, because if you go online and check out their organizations, they do an awful lot for our community. So please go out and check the displays after at our reception and have some cake and mingle and talk to some people. Dance with Viv will also be out there. She has a table for her organization as well. So check those displays out, and that would be wonderful. And thank you to those of you that did the displays, because they're quite nice. So after the next piece, we will be playing Poet and Peasant Overture by Supay. It's an overture to an operetta, and Jim Everett will be our soloist for that. But he's our principal player today, so he'll be doing his solo. But the next piece we're going to play is Cats. I thought last year, oh, the big movie's coming out, Cats. Yay, it's going to be great, I'll do Cats. And then the movie came out, and I was like, yuck, it's horrible. But the music is still good. Enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you. of applause for Jim Everett and his beautiful solo.
I have to say, that part for the violins was tough. And they did a great job. Good for you. Another round of applause for that. Celebrating Black History Month this month, so the three composers that I chose to do were Scott Joplin, Florence Price, and Duke Ellington. The next piece we're going to play is by Scott Joplin. I'm sure you've heard Maple Leaf Rag before, so that's going to be what we perform. There's not much known about Scott Joplin. He was born in either 1867 or 68, we're not sure which, and he died in 1917. He was raised in Texas. He wrote 40 rags, but the neat thing about him is that he actually wrote them down. They weren't just improv and they weren't just passed along. He actually wrote them down. And the Maple Leaf Rag, because of that, he was called the King of Ragtime. And he wrote down Maple Leaf Rag, and someone wanted to buy it from him, and he was smart enough to say, you're not going to just buy it from me, I want royalties on it. And then it sold 500,000 copies that year. So he was very lucky that he did that. And because of that, he had money to go to school, and he did actually write two operas. So if you ever have a chance to listen to his operas, they're very good. So it's kind of neat, you think of all of his entertainer and things like that, but he also wrote two operas. So the Maple Leaf Rag would be what we play next. But after that, we're playing a piece by Florence Price. It's called Dances in the Cane Brakes. And Florence Price was the first African-American woman, female, to ever have a piece performed by a major orchestra. She was the first to do that in 1933. And what had happened was she had moved to Chicago and she won a prize to be able to premiere a piece, which is very unique back in those days. Females even, as I've lectured, do every concert for many weeks or many years now. It's hard enough that she was African-American, so it was really difficult. So she had her piece premiered with the Chicago Symphony back in 1933. She tried to publish a bunch of her music, but of course, it's kind of sad if you look at her memoirs and things. She used to write letters to publishers that would say, I have two faults. I'm female and I'm African American. And they would not publish her music. So it's very sad to hear that. So her music got put in boxes and she put it in her attic in her summer home. And then in 2009, someone bought that home. No one knew about the music, and they found 30 boxes of her music up in this home. Yeah, so they started to now publish it and take it out and do it. And it's very exciting to see what's going to come out of it, because her music is very, very good and very exciting. So that's very interesting. That's Florence Price. So the piece that we'll play is her piano piece called Dances in the Cane Brakes. It was orchestrated by William Grant Still, who was also an African-American male, who was the first African-American male to compose a piece that was played and premiered by a major orchestra, the Rochester Philharmonic. And he was also the first African-American to conduct an orchestra back in 1936. So if you think about the time, the ridiculous times where people couldn't even enter the same door, he was able to actually conduct an orchestra. The LA Phil and the Hollywood Bowl. So his music is fabulous. He has hundreds of pieces. He wrote ballets, operas, all kinds of things. So it's interesting. So he orchestrated, which means he took Florence Price's piano piece and orchestrated and made it so that an orchestra could play it. And it's actually, you're gonna really enjoy this piece. If you listen carefully, you'll hear, if you think about a piano player, they're doing that thing. We can't do that up here, so he'll have the parts start over here and go over there and come back. And it's very neat, so listen carefully, you're going to love it.
Bye. Thank you. Thank you.
Piece for you by Duke Ellington. I appreciate your continued support. Those of you that donate to us and put money in our donation box, we're so grateful to that. We could not do the pieces that we do, like the one we just did, without those donations. So thank you for those of you that have been really pushing forward. We appreciate it very much. We do have an email list if you're interested. I was going to put a pad of paper out there, but I did not. Is there one out there by any chance? No. So if you would like to have it, give us your email, I can give you information and send your posters out, our programs, just let me know. I'll be out there afterward. It's a great way to help us support us, to publicize for us. We'd appreciate that. Our next event that we have is today. We have a refreshment, cake refreshment. Please stay, talk to us, check out the displays again from those wonderful organizations. Then we have on February 17th, we have our Pizza Hut fundraiser. In your program is a coupon. You just bring the coupon between 4 and 8, and we get 20%. So this would be a great time to treat your whole office, your staff, family, you know, anybody you want. That would be a great time. We'd appreciate it. On March 13th, we have our Chamber Ensemble Showcase at Creative 360. That is also free. All of our concerts and events are free. It's at Creative 360, and we have different groups that will be performing. It gives you a chance, if you have a wedding coming up, maybe you can hear these people play, and you can talk to them and hire them. And it's the idea is to give them some chamber ensemble experience. So if you can join us, that's on March 13th. And then our next concert is April 26th, here again at 3 o'clock. So keep those in mind. So our last piece today is by Duke Ellington. He was born in 1899, died in 1974. He was called the Duke because he was gentlemanly. And so they called him the Duke, because the Duke would be gentlemanly. He's a composer, a piano player, and of course the band leader. What you may not know about him is that he was offered a scholarship to go study music when he was 17, but he chose to go on the road and become famous that way, which is probably not a good idea for most of us, but for him it worked. At 17 he toured Europe, he's written so many pieces, recordings he's been in, movies, so I think you're going to love this piece. It's all the fun tunes, and I thank you again for being here.